now the real fun is about to begin. So I've got some rice cakes with some jelly and some M&Ms on them. And if you guys actually look closely at my rice cakes and my M&Ms, you can see that most of my M&Ms are red or orange. That's because they put a little cayenne pepper in those guys to make them red or make them orange. And that means that the thermic effect of food is a little bit higher on those guys than it is for like blue ones or green ones. Carbs, they're the devil, man. They are the antagonist, the enemy, the ultimate joker. And carbs and insulin, they go hand in hand. So what we need to figure out is how do we put our bodies in a position so that we can utilize our insulin to best process our carbs. In other words, how do we improve our insulin sensitivity? Hey, Jim Schultz here for F Cubed, man. Just rocking the cube, hitting the fitness angle today, trying to help you guys reach those physical fitness goals. And if you guys just found the channel, man, smash that subscribe button, join the movement, and buckle up until the end, because I've got something special for you guys here today. So truth be told, carbs are not the devil, but that's what a lot of people would lead you to believe. But nevertheless, man, growing up as a big kid, growing up as the fat kid in the group, man, I love me some carbs. I love me some carbs more than most things. Sorry, Mom. So over the years, man, I mean, I've had to figure all this stuff out. I mean, calories and macros, protein, carbs, and fats ratio. I mean, even when you start slipping into things like hormones, like insulin effects on the body, like insulin in bodybuilding as a competitive bodybuilder, like the actual insulin hormone function, I've had to figure all this stuff out basically through trial and error. And the whole idea of insulin sensitive versus insulin resistant is actually very, very important. So the difference between insulin sensitivity and insulin resistance is actually really, really simple. It's basically this. When you are insulin resistant, your body literally has a hard time absorbing or accepting the nutrients, or specifically the glucose, that your insulin is trying to send into the organs and send into the muscles. Now, conversely, if you are insulin sensitive, then those same cells in your organs, in your muscles, will readily accept the nutrients, the glucose, the carbohydrates that you feed your body. Basically, it comes down to how efficient your body is at processing glucose. So what I want to do here today is I want to give you guys three ways to become more efficient at processing those carbohydrates, to improve your insulin sensitivity and help you control those blood sugar fluctuations. So number one, you could lower your carbohydrate intake. Now this, I think, is a big reason why something like keto is so popular. And I did a three-part series on keto, so check that guy out if you haven't seen it yet, so that you can figure out if keto makes sense for you. But basically, if you do reduce your carbohydrate intake, it is going to improve your insulin sensitivity. It is going to kind of retrain your body to become more efficient at processing carbohydrates. But I think many people think that carbs make you fat, which that's a little bit misplaced. It's actually a lot more nuanced than that. And so people kind of thinking along those lines are like, yeah, I'm just going to ditch all the carbs. I'm just going keto. I don't want to have to think about a glycemic index diet. I don't want to have to think about high glycemic carbohydrates or low glycemic carbohydrates or the best low glycemic foods or whatever. I'm just going to ditch all the carbs. I'm going to be done with it and I'm going to be shredded. Well, this will help with insulin sensitivity, but I wouldn't call it, you know, just the perfect insulin resistance cure. I mean, it's not going to be necessarily a panacea to all your carbohydrate-laden problems. Tip number two, it's very simple, weight training. Just get in the gym and get some work done, man. The simple act of resistance training will help your body become more efficient at regulating that glucose and improve that insulin sensitivity. Tip number three is actually gonna be how lean you are. It's basically gonna be your lean body mass to fat mass ratio. The leaner you are, the more efficient your body becomes at processing carbohydrates. The more insulin sensitive you become just by being lean. And so it might seem like you have a faster metabolism, but it's actually just your body turning over those carbohydrates more efficiently. So there you go, man. 3 tips to help you guys improve that insulin sensitivity and become a pancake processing machine. Hey, speaking of 3 tips, man, I've got 3 tips to help you guys torch your body fat, man. I've got 3 tips ready to go for you guys. Nutrition, weight training, cardio, totally free, that you can download right now in the description to this video, and you will melt that body fat off of your frame. So let's wrap it up with a quick Q&A. Question number 1, what causes insulin spikes? Well, carbs do. And protein. And fats. Oh. Question number 2, do carbs make you fat? No. Eating like you just broke out of prison all day, day makes you fat. And lastly, most importantly, question number 3, pancakes or waffles? Waffles, and then pancakes. So that's it. That's all I got, man. Hit me with that like, share, subscribe. See you guys next time.